ABM stands for Aeronautical Decision Making, and the FAA's definition says that it is a systematic approach to the mental process used by pilots to have a consistent, safe outcome of each flight. So the pilots should have some kind of system that they use to always keep themselves safe. And that begins with checking yourself to make sure you're okay before you ever go fly. The acronym that the FAA uses is the I'm Safe model. And what that stands for is illness, medications, stress, alcohol, fatigue, eating, and hydration. With the illness, even a mild cold or a minor cold could affect your flight. When you take off and you climb higher, usually your ears will clear, but on the way back down, often you could develop ear block where your eustachian tube is so inflamed that it doesn't allow your ears to clear. It can be very, very painful as well as cause permanent damage. So even a minor cold could affect you physically and also mentally because, you know, when you're congested and you feel achy or sore, you can't think as clearly. M is for your medications. The FAA's website has a list of medication that may prevent somebody from even receiving their medical, but also even over-the-counter drugs such as Benadryl or NyQuil should absolutely not be taken and then go fly because it's going to impair your judgment, especially in times of emergency situations. The S stands for stress. If you're under a great deal of stress, for example, at your work or maybe at your home life or relationship, you may feel that you're okay to go fly. And as long as the flight goes well, you're probably okay. But what happens when the weather gets bad or there's an emergency situation, maybe electrical failure or smoke in the cockpit, if you're already stressed out in your normal life, you may not be able to handle that additional stress during your flight. A stands for alcohol, and the regulation says that we must have at least 8 hours bottle to throttle, meaning that you shouldn't have drank any alcohol within 8 hours, but it depends on how much alcohol you may have drank and how quickly your body metabolizes that. Someone might be okay in 8 hours, but somebody else might not be okay for 12 or 24 hours. And then also the blood alcohol content is 0.04. The F stands for fatigue. If you're very, very tired, you're not likely to think clearly, specifically in the event of emergency. And then the E for eating and hydration. It's very important that you take care of yourself as a pilot. Even though flying is fun, it's very demanding on your body. So if you haven't eaten for a long time, your blood sugar levels may not be normal. And certainly if you're not hydrated properly, your thought process may not be as clear. So the FAA recommends that you do an I'm Safe check before you intend on going to fly. Now, another model that they have is the DECIDE model. And what the DECIDE model is for is to help you if a problem arose in the aircraft, that you would recognize that there's a problem and do something about it and not just have a knee-jerk reaction. So the DECIDE model, it stands for first that you would detect the problem, and that E, that you estimate, you know, the severity of that problem and should you do something about it. And then you choose whether you should do something or not. And then you identify your different choices, and then you actually do something, and then you estimate or evaluate what you did, does it work or not. So let's use an example of maybe a rough running engine. So you're flying along and your engine starts to run a little rough. Well, first of all, you detected it. And then you have to evaluate, should I do something about this or is it okay till I get to my destination? And then you choose that you should do something about it. This is a problem. And then you could identify the different choices. So should you change your fuel, enrich in your mixture, pull carburetor heat on, check your mags, you know, what do you want to do? And you decide, well, I think I'll check my magnetos. So then you actually check your magnetos. And when you went from both to the right mag, the engine ran very nicely. So you are just going to leave it and evaluate that that was the proper thing to do. So that's your DECIDE model. And the attempt is to make sure that you don't just have a knee-jerk reaction, that you think logically about a pending problem and respond accordingly. The next thing is five hazardous attitudes that are really big reasons why people crash. And starting with macho, it means that a person thinks that they can do it, even though they might not be able to. It could be where they want to go into weather that they're not trained properly for, they shouldn't be going into anyway, or maybe it's you know, going into an aircraft that they've never flown before. Even though your private pilot allows you to fly almost any single engine airplane, just because you've been flying Cessnas doesn't mean that you should necessarily go jump in a Piper or a Beechcraft without having any further training. So that might be the macho attitude where you think you can do it no matter what. Anti-authority has to do with people not wanting to follow the rules and regulations. Now keep in mind that most of those regulations were written because of accidents, or we say they're written in blood. You know, somebody maybe became hypoxic at high altitude, so they imposed the oxygen regulation on us. So it's good to follow the rules. Impulsivity means that you do something too quickly without thinking first. So just take your time. Usually there's no need to respond too quickly with anything unless the aircraft were on fire. Other than that, you know, if you had an engine problem, you try to solve it. If the engine quit, you trim for your best glide speed and go through what you've been trained to do. Don't be too impulsive. And vulnerability means that you think it won't happen to you. And this typically shows up in younger people because most young people think that they're going to live to be 60, 70, or 80. So they don't think that anything bad could happen, but it could. So be very cautious and use your checklist and you know, a good attitude about flying. Resignation is when somebody just tends to give up. Oh, what's the use? It's a rough running engine. It must be my time. Well, you know, don't give up. Use the decide model and, you know, try to troubleshoot and fix the problem. And then risk elements are part of your ADM as well. And the risk elements are you, the pilot, the environment or the weather, the aircraft, and finally the mission. So the pilot can be a risk element specifically because of these attitudes that human nature causes us to display. The environment is that the weather, even though we have the weather people have great forecasting abilities, sometimes surprises still occur with the weather. The aircraft, it's mechanical, and mechanical things break, so of course it's a risk element. The mission is pretty important. You know, why did you make that flight? Was it because you wanted to take your friends out and you know, you're trying to be too macho when you shouldn't have flown that day? Or maybe the mission is you're hired as a pilot and the pressure from your company is causing you to go fly or do something you wouldn't have normally done. So the mission itself could also be a risk element. So ADM, aeronautical decision making, is extremely important. This is why people crash, or I should say the lack thereof ADM is why people crash. And the FAA thinks it's so important that it is a special emphasis area on your check ride.